This historic pick, first time ever the Chicago Blackhawks have had the first pick. We proudly select Patrick Kane.
He's going to be a dynamic player for this organization.
Here's a chance and a shot by Taves, and he scores his first NHL goal in his first NHL game.
It doesn't get much better for a rookie than that one.
2-on-1 for Chicago. Kane's going down the slot. He's got the puck. Score! Oh, boy!
If you're going to score your first NHL goal, that's the kind of goal you want to score.
From the face-off, the wrist shot.
Yeah! Yeah!
Wins it in overtime!
Attaboy, Pat Kane!
Shot fought off by Hasek. Rebound, Kane, and he scores! Patrick Kane, 21 of the year.
It's so important when that puck, look where Kane goes. He comes to the traffic area. If he stays on the outside and plays on the perimeter, he doesn't have a wide open net.
And the winner is Patrick Kane.
Dale, thanks for picking me last year. I know it was a gutsy move picking a 5'9", 160-pound guy first overall, but thank you. I appreciate it. John McDonough, it looks like we have the Hawks going again, and it's good to be part of it.
Traffic and weather update, then Patrick Kane in studio, your NHL Rookie of the Year. Earlier today, we got the official announcement. Frankly, there would have been a riot in the streets if it didn't go down this way. Your National Hockey League Rookie of the Year, Patrick Kane. I mean, is it one of those deals, Patrick, where until you hear, you just don't believe it's true?
Yeah, I guess so. I mean, you hear a lot of things that, you have a good chance of winning. But, I was probably nervous more than anyone in that building last night to see what went down. But, it was a good ending to the day and, a fun night.
What a year, huh?
Yeah. I mean, from graduating high school to getting drafted first overall and then playing a full year at the Blackhawks, couldn't have went any better, I don't think. And I had a lot of fun this year.
So here comes the former London Knight Jr., Patrick Kane on Hasek. Scores! You're watching the future of the Chicago Blackhawks right there.
Hi, I'm Patrick Kane.
And I'm Jonathan Taves.
Apparently, you had as much fun as we did at the United.
Okay, that's all right. You're there.
I'll say the point.
You're there.
We'll conduct the stretch. He threw out the first pitches today.
I still think it would be a good idea to put the ball on.
Hey, Cubs fans. Can't wait to see you all on New Year's Day, so let's hear ya. Let me hear ya. 1, 2, 3.
Take me out to the ball game. Take me out with the crowd. Buy me some peanuts and crackers next. I don't care if I ever get back.
Early Sunday morning, South Buffalo native Pat Kane was arrested over an alleged dispute with a cab driver. Now that cab driver is telling his side of the story to News 4. News 4's Tricia Cruz is live in our newsroom with more right now. Tricia.
Well, in the words of the cab driver, Patrick Kane and his cousin went berserk once their cab ride came to an end in Buffalo at about 4:30 this morning. This cab driver says the cuts and bruises on his face are from NHL star Patrick Kane and his 21-year-old cousin. Patrick Kane, who is only 20, plays for the Chicago Blackhawks.
One guy pays and the other guy grabs him by the throat. The Patrick Kane could turn out to be a hockey player. I don't know who they are.
The cab driver, who only wants us to use his initials of JR, tells News 4 people in the neighborhood heard the commotion and recognized the hockey player. The drama unfolded when Patrick Kane and his cousin James hailed JR's cab on Chippewa Street at about 4 in the morning. The two ended their ride here on Eastwood Place in Buffalo, and the cab driver says this is where the trouble began and all over 20 cents. The fare came to $13.80. JR says the Canes gave him 15, but he could only give them a dollar.
I didn't have 20 cents to give change. I said, I don't have the change.
All of a sudden, according to JR and the police report he filed,
the one Kane is choking me, the other one's punching me. Don't you know who I am? Don't you know who I am? He says, you're messing with the wrong people. I didn't have the 20 cents to give him change.
The cabbie accuses Patrick and James of taking the rest of his money, and that's not all.
My glasses are busted. My shirt's tore open.
Patrick and James entered a not guilty plea in court. We spotted them walking away once they left the courthouse. Patrick is wearing a blue baseball cap, a gray t-shirt, and gray shorts. Their attorney made a brief statement.
Arraigned and adjourned. What was the plea?
Not guilty.
As for the option to say anything else.
No, thank you.
So this is it. I'll let my lawyer talk about it later.
Patrick Kane and his cousin are charged with robbery and criminal mischief. In a statement, the Chicago Blackhawks say it's aware of the allegations, and while it's still collecting all the facts, the team stands behind Kane, who is considered a team leader and a big part of the organization. Trisha Cruz, News 4 at 6. In other news tonight, NHL star Patrick Kane and his cousin pleaded guilty to charges over a scuffle with a Buffalo cab driver. News 4's Melissa Holmes has more now on their punishment.
How do you plead to that charge?
Chicago Blackhawks star and South Buffalo native Patrick Kane and his cousin James stood before a judge and pled guilty to disorderly conduct. That's a violation equivalent to a traffic ticket.
I mean, obviously, I'm sorry about the situation with us or Mr. Radecki, and, obviously, I'm in a little bit of a different situation than most kids at this age, but at the same time, I think
tough 2.5 weeks for me here, but I'm happy that the matter's finally behind me. I think, obviously, you want to apologize again to my family, the city of Buffalo. My teammates, the whole Blackhawks organization, obviously all the fans out there, my fans especially.
Kane added he wants to put this all behind him and move forward with the Blackhawks and hopefully the Olympics. Melissa Holmes, News 4.
I've been very lucky to achieve every kid's dream of playing in the National Hockey League, let alone for a great organization like the Chicago Blackhawks. Now I also have a chance to play for my country, a dream come true for myself and also my family. I know everyone wants to talk about what happened in Buffalo. As you know, the legal proceedings are pending, and I cannot discuss the details at this time. Because I put myself in being in the wrong position in the wrong time, I've caused a lot of pain for my family, my hometown of Buffalo, the city of Chicago, the Chicago Blackhawks, and obviously the great fans we have here in Chicago. And for that part, I sincerely apologize. Now it's time for me to move forward. I'm excited to get back to the ice and represent the Chicago Blackhawks and the United States Olympic hockey team. Thank you.
Jeez,
you're a little old, Mark.
That's gonna take me a while.
You ain't good.
I heard.
It's gotta be a good strategy,
this. I'm gonna tell you my trick right now because I'm gonna beat you anyways, but you chew it and you swallow it.
Not offensive, Pete.
So do I. It hurts.
Obviously not.
Team Canada. 4-0.
Oh, that does hurt right now, bro.
Hey, Blackhawks fans and Team USA fans, it's Patrick Kane. February 22nd, just got this camera. Hopefully I'll be guiding you through my Olympic experience with me. It's been a real treat so far, and day after we just beat the Canadians. So today's gonna be a low key day. Just gonna hang out with my parents and hopefully just chill and relax. And after that, I'm sure you'll see a lot of fun. So hope you enjoy.
It's a pretty cool atmosphere, as you can see. Obviously it's pretty hostile too for us American players, but.
USA house on the pillows. Pretty comfortable spot for the athletes just to hang out. Okay, so what do we got here in this room?
You just choose one of the 5 backgrounds here. Choose a pose, and we superimpose your body or your head into the various Olympic backgrounds. We've got lots of wardrobe accessories.
Nice, let's do it.
We'll be right back.
Papa Kane going next.
That's great. Can't smile.
I was brutal again, but hopefully I worked it out in my system, you know?
We just beat the Swiss 2-0.
How do you feel?
Feel good.
Why?
Because we just advanced the medal rounds. Billsy was sick again, and we got to win, and now we're going to play Finland.
This is free McDonald's. How many times have you ate it this week?
It's my first time. I tried to stay light. What's it like for you two to videotape each other and look like idiots? Why don't you do it again? Get this on there, huh?
Just tell us what we're doing right now, Jack.
We're waiting for the women's hockey team here to give a good send off.
Who do we just beat?
Fins.
Going to the gold medal? Woo! Get those tunes going. Get those going.
All pretty exciting right now. It's a pretty good moment, obviously. You know, we're moving on to the gold medal game, and got to be happy. So it's been a great couple of weeks, and looking forward to the game. You know, it's a tough feeling right now. We got a silver medal.
You're like a bad man, Gus.
You know, I think gold will be on our reach in 2014. We'll be older and more experienced, and hopefully this just helps us along the way.
All right, you've seen my room. But now it's time for me to have some privacy, so you gotta go. Get out of here.
It goes with him. He's a pretty disgusting looking human being, just to start it off.
It looks really good, especially the little details in the sideburns there, the steps.
I don't want to offend anybody from my hometown of Thunder Bay or anyone in Canada, but looks like he's trying to hop the border there and become a Canadian with that haircut. I like AC/DC and ZZ Top. We'll see this beat. The middle comes Brian Campbell heading for the net. Patrick Kane shoots, he scores!
Troy Brower holds the puck in. Bounced on Mitchell, a wraparound tee, scores! Here's Kane with Taves. Kane, backhand shot, he scores!
Even from the start of the first, we were playing good. They had a power play, and then they got kind of a good bounce there on their second goal. I fell, and you know, I thought we were skating the whole time, and you know, give them credit, they came hard in the third and tied it up.
And the guy who scored the winning goal that was not seen right away, Patrick Kane, is with Pierre.
Are you the only person in this building that thought that puck went in?
I knew it went in right away. It was stuck behind the mesh in the net there. Got a shout out to my people back in Buffalo, my hometown. I got four buddies down. They drove all the way to come watch me play. My five family members, three sisters, three beautiful sisters, my mom and dad. What a feeling. I can't believe it. It's unbelievable. We just won the Stanley Cup.
The rebirth of the Chicago Blackhawks started with you and Jonathan Toews. Did you think you'd get to the top of the mountain this quickly?
I can't believe this just happened. Holy crap. I mean, it's something you dream of as a kid, to score the winning goal in the Stanley Cup Finals. And it was just, it was... I mean, it's unbelievable.
Be on your best behavior at the parade, Patrick.
Not a chance, not a chance.
Have fun. Doc, that's youthful enthusiasm.
I guess so.
How many times do you guys think he's kissed that cup today?
I,
I think 10 just since he stopped in front of us. These players off of these buses at some point. I'm not sure how exactly that's going to work. And get them over to the staging area. Do you know how they're doing that?
I don't know.
At their football. To Patrick Kane there from the crowd.
Yeah, it looks like they just threw him a beer, and I think Patrick Kane knows how to handle a beer. What is he going to do? Can we go back to the cup there?
They're drinking it out of the cup now. They're party that's going on. It's like Kane's dancing on one end of one bus.
Oh,
here
shirt.
He goes.
Oh, no.
He is loving this crowd, and they're loving him back.
Surrounded by fans.
And look at this picture. Like, these two gals are probably putting that up on their Facebook page.
I guarantee you that.
Just about as many people, a sea of people. They're not even able to see the stage, but they just want to be near this team and near these double-decker buses.
Chicago! This is unbelievable. I'll tell you one thing, I'll try to keep my shirt on all summer, just for you guys, for all the cab drivers out there. I love you.
Came home today carrying his coveted prize, and he was followed by a sea of fans from Niagara Falls to Buffalo. Let's go live to News 4 senior correspondent Rich Newberg at New Era Cap. Rich.
What a day it was, Jackie. Take a look at the sign behind me here at New Era. Pat's home and the Stanleys with him. It was a day of adventure for Pat Kane and his fans. He covered a lot of ground with the Stanley Cup and even went airborne. Now, here at New Era, he met with Buffalo Police and Fire Department members and their families and touched a lot of bases in his hometown today. And he even accepted an invitation to be hoisted up on a Buffalo fire ladder as part of a visit with Fire and Police Department members. And the ladder got stuck for about 20 minutes. The bucket eventually did come down. Now, here is a look back on a packed day for the Chicago Blackhawk, who won the cup for his team in overtime but never forgot his roots.
With the majestic falls as a backdrop and surrounded by family and friends, South Buffalo hockey hero Patrick Kane held up Lord Stanley's Cup high in the air. He was on the newly named Hurricane Deck of the Cave of the Winds. It was a thrill for his fans.
That's just awesome. Like, whoa.
And for the trophy winner.
You know, just getting drenched up there gives you a total rush. And it was really a great moment to hold the cup over my head.
Mayor Paul Dyster, who gave Kane the key to the city, said the falls provided a Kodak moment worthy of the cup.
Well, you have to have something to compete here with the Eiffel Tower, I guess, right, where the cup was on Monday.
Patrick was humbled at his next stop. He brought the cup to young cancer patients at Roswell Park.
It's really hard not to get emotional up there. I thought it was really tough, especially kids walking in and out, you know, their heads are shaved and they just got the smile from ear to ear.
He signed autographs in a packed lobby at Roswell, but told me he felt the cup was a bigger attraction for the kids.
We're excited about the cup. I think they were excited to meet you too.
Probably more about the cup. I mean, look at that thing. It's beautiful. It's got so much history behind it.
Everywhere Pat went, he made history in Western New York, even if it meant venturing six stories up at the construction site of the new Heart and Vascular Institute, where iron workers had written Kane Wins Stanley Cup on a beam. He hoisted the cup with family friend Terry Prendergast beside him.
You know, it's nice to come back to Buffalo and be a part of your hometown and try to get back to the city as much as possible. And that's what we're just trying to do here.
Now, coming up, we'll hear from some of his young fans and more from Pat as he toured his hometown with the cup. Reporting live at New Era Cap, Rich Newberg, News 4 at 5.
Everyone says Kane and Taves all the time.
Quit whining. It just sounds better.
Well, I am the youngest captain in the league right now.
Yeah, but you're only the third youngest ever. I was the first overall pick in 2007, won the Calder Trophy.
I scored my first goal, my first shot in the NHL, so, you know, no big deal.
Kane could end it here. He's done it 8 times before. My goodness. That's it.
Ring in the new year with Patrick Kane.
I got hit in the head with a puck that I hold.
Pat Kane with a sign.
Another young guy. Oh, here we go.
Superman.
Teamwork.
There we go.
Oh, here we go.
Elliot's doing a lap of his net. He's getting ready too.
The shades. Marquette. Super Kane.
Oh, beauty.
Might have just vaulted into the lead. Chicago Blackhawks, Patrick Kane.
The broken puck.
The disintegrating puck.
Did part of it go in? He's so strong, he can break it.
Schneider, se Kane sbaglia vince Lambrì. Kane contro Schneider, segna Kane.
More drama in your sci-fi? Patrick Kane's got it.
It's all Obi-Wan's fault. He's jealous. He's holding me back.
Here's another chance for Chicago. Net empty.
You know, it's kind of surreal right now, to be honest with you. To be back in the finals and have that opportunity again. And, you know, the best part about it is we get to start at home where we've been good all year. And we fought all year to get that home ice advantage. So it's nice to stay here in Chicago and start the next two games here.
Well, enjoy and good luck.
Thank you.
Conn Smythe Trophy as the most valuable player in the playoffs is Patrick Kane.
Patrick Kane had a terrific start to the season, slowed towards the end of it, but when he went back with his buddy Jonathan Toews in the playoffs, he started to score again. And the Blackhawks beat Los Angeles, and they put him back with Toews in this series, and he scored again. Big goals for Patrick Kane, and he takes the Conn Smythe Trophy.
I feel like we've done this dance before. It's Patrick Kane and all of his buddies from Buffalo.
Let's go, baby.
Let's go, baby.
So tell us about those last few minutes. I mean, you had to be start thinking about there was going to be a Game 7 back in Chicago.
Yeah, I mean, you think you're going back for Game 7, and, you know, we score a goal to make it 2-2. You think you're going into overtime to regroup and get ready for the overtime, and you score 17 seconds later. To be honest with you, it's kind of a blur right now, but it's a great feeling.
What's up, Chicago? The only reason this day is fun is because of all you guys coming out and supporting this team. It makes hockey fun. There's a saying I said throughout the playoffs that represents this team perfectly. That's hockey, baby!
There's so many reasons that played out this season. Drama like this is like watching Shakespeare. But what they were doing was crushing those ruins. In 17 seconds, your cup will win.
Take her up. There she is. I thought it was pretty important for me to bring it out here because, you know, I can carry this stuff around and carry a 35-pound cup, like you said, but, you know, you guys carry the country and do a lot for us. So I appreciate everything. I know my family does and everyone that's here. It's a pretty emotional day to be here. So thanks for having me. Looking forward to everything we're doing today.
Pilots are really focused a lot on these instruments right here. Blue side up is sky, black side down is the ground. Yeah. We focus right there a lot, but mostly we want our attention outside the windows.
Those are four different engines?
Yep, one column per motor.
What's up, guys?
Just want to thank all you guys for coming. It means a lot to me. Seeing the support from Buffalo, and hopefully we can get some pictures and have a good time, eat some food. So, once again, thanks for coming.
Valuable player. Ladies and gentlemen, from your 2013 Stanley Cup champion Chicago Blackhawks, here's Patrick Kane. Patrick, come on.
This is
quite a playoff, wasn't it? I mean, the finals, you and the Boston, just tremendous. Was it good hockey from a player's standpoint?
Yeah, I thought it was great hockey, to be honest with you. You know, anytime you win, I guess it's a little bit more exciting, especially for your team. But just a great run, especially from, you know, everything that went on this year with, you know, the lockout and our winning streak.
Are they thinking about shortening the season by half every year because of the Cup playoffs were so exciting? And I said, yeah. Well, of course, they only played 40 games.
I guess, you know, ratings were up as high as ever. So it was a good year for hockey.
And compare this to your previous Chicago Blackhawks Stanley Cup win. When was that, 2009?
2010.
And what was it like then? You're just a kid now. How old were you then?
I was 21 then, so you know, legal to do all the fun stuff after we won. But you know, both you can't really compare either one to each other. I think both teams are so different, but a lot of players stepped up, and it was a fun ride.
So tell me about the ice in Boston for the final game. Was it okay? Was it not okay?
Yeah, it was. That was probably the worst ice I've ever skated on.
Is that right?
It's so chippy, and it's almost like the ice is like sweating. It's so hot in there. It's crazy.
And to what degree do you have to alter your game when the ice is like that?
You have to keep things simple. That's the biggest thing. You know, try not to do too much. I myself get my team in trouble a little bit trying to do too much sometimes. But you know, if you keep it simple, it ends up working out for everyone.
You know, for as long as I've been watching hockey, everybody has said there's a difference between regular season hockey and playoff hockey. And oh my God, if that wasn't supported in this playoffs, I don't know what was. Explain to me what that difference is.
I think the intensity just, you know, ramps up a little bit.
Yeah, but I mean, you say that is one thing, but to see it, it's like crazy men out there.
Yeah, it's, you know, you should see the locker room after games. I mean, from ice bags to IVs to guys getting, you know, shot up, it's really, you know, quite a scene.
I mean, certain medicinal, you got a thing, you know, and sometimes you need a shot.
Exactly.
I know my hockey. And then the other thing, oh my God, hockey is so wonderful. Now explain to me, and it's impossible to try, the symbolism of the Stanley Cup and the tangible, the actual Stanley Cup. Tell us about the lore and the myth and legend of those two things. As a symbol, what does that mean?
It's unbelievable. You know, we've been, you know, parading around Chicago the past couple nights, and you know, wherever that thing is, people tend to want to be there and be around it. It's what we believe is the coolest trophy in sports. It's you know, unbelievable to look at. I mean, it feels like you know, you're lifting 35 pounds, but it feels like nothing when you're lifting it, especially on the ice after winning.
And every man on the team gets it for a while, and you get to do whatever you want with it. Is that true?
Yeah.
So what are you going to do with it?
Yeah, I'm not sure yet. Last time I did some pretty cool things, you know, charity things, you know, kind of paraded around the city of Buffalo. I had it for a day in Chicago, took it to the Jimmy Buffett concert, which I guess is
nice you could get a date.
It's actually coming up Saturday in Chicago, the Buffett concert, so
yeah.
Might have to make a return.
But there are other things people do with a cup.
Like?
You know, just stuff. You know what I mean?
I think
there's another category of activity.
There's a lot of stuff that probably doesn't need to be said on the show. But,
that's right. But now the other thing that's great about hockey and from just a spectator standpoint, hockey makes NFL football look like the third grade field hockey. I mean, it is nonstop. And then at the end of the Stanley Cup, the handshake. Oh, my God. So you've been on the winning side of the handshake now twice.
Yep.
The Bruins got a man up and shake your hands after getting thumped in there in the last 17, 90 seconds, whatever it was. So what is that handshake moment like?
You know what? I think it's a awesome thing for the playoffs. I think, you know, you have so much respect for the other team. You don't really show it too much throughout the series, but when it's after, to shake the other team's hand, and you know, I had a couple buddies on Boston too that you shake their hands, you can see the disappointment in their faces and in their voice, but it's a great thing for the sport.
Yeah, it's hard to imagine gathering up one's emotions if you've lost that and then go shake the hands of the team that has vanquished you.
Yeah, it's I mean, I haven't had to do it in the Stanley Cup final, but
yeah, well, you're a lucky man. Oh, here, I wanted you to have this before you go.
Thank you.
That's your Conn Smythe right there.
What's the taser moonwalk?
You don't know it.
You may be about to find out.
Not a chance. I'll do the shuffle if he does the moonwalk.
Somebody get up.
I'm not on the ice. I can't slide around like Michael Jackson here. It's not the same. I'm sorry.
If we had any sense, we'd end it right there, wouldn't we?
I'd say Kane won.
Oh, thanks.
Well, you would.
That's the center ice. Kane makes an empty little move, gets it to the forehand. Take the shot, he scores! Patrick Kane celebrates with the hometown crowd wearing Chicago jerseys along the glass.
Walking out of the corner, right to the goal. He shoots, he scores! Patrick Kane, nobody came to him. He took the puck right to the net. It's 1-0, 62 seconds in.
Imagine that point to heaven after that goal was to him.
Yeah, it's a tough day overall. And, you know, it's one of my, you know, great friends growing up. And just a, you know, really sad day. So, it's, it was important to get the win, but anytime you get someone, you know, taken away from you, that's so close to you, it, you know, means so much. So it was tough to hear that right before the game, for sure.
Just talk about this game and as far as you guys getting back on the right track offensively tonight.
Yeah. I thought, you know, I knew before the game that this team was going to have a good response after last game in San Jose. That was, you know, a tough loss in a shootout, but a great game overall. So it was, you know, nice to come back and put up some goals. And even though we let in three, you know, we scored a lot tonight, and it seemed like everyone was moving it pretty good, moving it around, even on the power play. So it was a great effort from everyone, for sure.
I'm guessing Bickle let out a good scream after that goal.
Yeah, it was a great play. You know, Shazzy gave me the puck, and you know, he kind of made the whole play, coming in and taking away that defenseman. And you know, all I had to do was kind of fake the shot and pass it to Bix, and he wired that one home pretty hard, so I'm sure it was a good feeling for him.
Hi, I'm Patrick Kane. So excited to be going to Sochi. Please use the hashtag Cheers to Sochi. Cheer on me and my Olympic teammates.
Car incident rare in ice hockey. Patrick Kane took the penalty shot, but was foiled by goalkeeper Tuukka Rask. The miss, much to the relief of Timonen, penalty shot the outcome. Kane entrusted with the task of trying to score, having missed earlier. There was more frustration as the puck struck the post and stayed out of the goal. It just wasn't the USA's day, and things score the USA 0, Finland 5. The USA finishing the men's ice hockey competition in fourth place. A great team effort from Finland, winners of the bronze medal at Sochi 2014.
Good crunch put on Brookbank. Brookbank sees this one, battled for it, the half boards, Bickle turning it.
Come back to Chicago, the Blackhawks lead 1-0. That's Patrick Kane. Brendan Morrow is going to go into Sheldon Brookbank, bounce off him, and go right in to the left leg of Patrick Kane. That doesn't look very good.
Puck playing on the far side, and Sharp rolls it across now for Kane. Kane across the line, crisscrosses. Take the drop pass, carries it through the backhand shot. He scores! Patrick Kane is only he can do.
Do this. Patrick Kane on the backhand from such a bad angle, controls the puck, keeps it, and scores from there. The only place you can score on a goaltender.
Played at center by Saad. Has Kane with him. Patrick Kane holds. Kane now carries out. In a high slot. Kane with a shot. He scores! Patrick Kane has given the Blackhawks the lead.
Martinez looks at the net. Score! LA Kings are going to the final. It's another strange-looking goal shot from the blue line. And the LA Kings have defeated the defending Stanley Cup champions, the Chicago Blackhawks.
Back of the net, and what a big goal for ex-Ottawa 67. Two goals tonight.
Toffoli's eighth from Martinez and Williams. And the time was 5:47. If you're into that stuff, the two goalies say, nice going. See you next time. And the next time for Chicago will be next season.
NHL free agency signings. The Chicago Blackhawks sign center Brad Richards.
Jonathan Toews, Patrick Kane, 8-year extensions with the Hawks. It is done. They are signed through 2022-23. So after the World Cup in Qatar. So it's a done deal. Leaf fans, you just missed them. Sorry. Get them next time.
So here's Kane with loads of moves. What will he do on this one? He scores! Threw it around. Patrick Kane.
Ooh! Oh, bad. Oh, what a play from behind. Terrible move by Petrovic. An awkward fall to the boards by the NHL's leading point producer. Fortunately, starting to scrape himself up off the ice.
Blackhawks forward Patrick Kane underwent shoulder surgery on Wednesday. He's expected to miss 3 months.
Well, this is exciting. The Blackhawks could have their superstar back for the playoff opener this weekend. Or this week, I should say. Patrick Kane was full contact in practice today. And Coach Joe Quenneville says if he feels good tomorrow, he might suit up and play in the playoff opener Wednesday night in Nashville. Kane has been out 7 weeks with a broken collarbone.
This will be a pass into Kane, and scores! Up to Kane, he's got some room, you know what he can do with it. Gets in front, shoots, scores! Moving back up with Kane, drops it to Richard, across to Kane, he scores!
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the Stanley Cup.
Well, Chicago, that's three cups in six seasons. I'd say you have a dynasty.
The insurance goal. The American born favorite.
According to the Buffalo News, police are investigating an accusation of sexual assault against Patrick Kane of the Chicago Blackhawks. The Buffalo News is reporting that police in Hamburg, New York are investigating an incident that occurred last weekend. According to the report, officers in Hamburg have been forbidden to speak about the investigation. Gregory G. Wickett, the chief of police, told the Buffalo News, quote, "We can neither confirm nor deny the existence or non-existence of a criminal investigation until such a time as a person is charged with a crime." And
this has been an incredibly difficult time for many people. I cannot apologize enough for the distraction this has caused my family, my teammates, this incredible organization, and of course our fans. While I have too much respect for the legal process to comment on an ongoing matter, I am confident that once all of the facts are brought to light, I will be absolved of having done nothing wrong.
Thank you, John and Patrick. Appreciate that.
Explosive new developments today in the Patrick Kane rape investigation.
Yesterday, the rape kit evidence bag was anonymously delivered to the home of my client's mother.
The attorney for the alleged victim wants to know who tampered with the evidence.
This is a classic example why rape victims don't come forward.
My question is that someone who's not happy with the results?
Live team coverage begins right now.
Here ends the criminal end of the Patrick Kane saga.
No charges will be filed against NHL superstar Patrick Kane.
One of the top foreign free agents will be coming to Chicago. Artemi Panarin has agreed to terms with the Blackhawks. Panarin's coming off a KHL championship season for SKA St. Petersburg.
which was a good goal call on the ice, and Patrick Kane has kept his team season alive.
And the Hart Trophy goes to Patrick Kane.
This is Patrick Kane's third NHL award of the evening and the fifth of his career. He's the first Chicago Blackhawk to win the Hart since Stan Mikita in 1968.
Thank you very much. I can honestly say that Batman Returns is my favorite movie growing up, so
thank you.
To receive this award from Michael Keaton, the best Batman ever, thank you very much. That's awesome. Obviously, I got to congratulate Jamie and Sid on tremendous years, especially Sid on the Cup. You guys are two of my favorite players in the game, and I love watching you guys on TV every night. I want to give a shout out to my best buddy back home, Mike Rout. Thanks for all the support with everything. And lastly, our fans in Chicago. We have the best fans, whether it's at home or on the road. We travel so well, and it's almost like every game's a home game for us. So thank you very much. And Dad, this one's for you. I love you.
Welcome to Jackets TV, presented by Ohio.
Joined right now by Patrick Kane, who is the reigning Hart Trophy winner. He was the MVP of the NHL last year. Patrick, I want to start there because you became the first American-born player to win that trophy, to get that honor. What does that mean to you?
Well, I think first off, it's kind of, you know, shocking that I am the first, because there's been so many great American players that have, you know, come through before me. When you look at some of the names of, you know, Medano and Chelios, Jeremy Roenick, Pat LaFontaine, some amazing players that have been in the league for a long time, you think their name would be on the trophy. So I think for me, I was just kind of shocked to hear that at first. But, you know, it's pretty exciting. You think of all the kids that put on a pair of skates and try to play the game of hockey. For you to be the one that's, you know, won the MVP award the first time, I think there will be more in the future. The future's bright for USA Hockey, but it's definitely an honor.
Down low. Kane.
Price makes the save, but he stays with it. Right here, he contains it up into the shirt and then followed it down with the whack at it into the back of the net. 2-0 USA.
I got this. Game over.
Does this so well. Is there's the first chance, first of all, by Kane. Watch Taves here. There, that quick stick, and then he whacks it right to Kane, and then Kane with his magic. And all is that magic. There's that little play by Taves. Oh, wow. That's just special.
As Panarin has it back for Chicago, sends it back in front. Patrick Kane with time. Wade's backhand shot. Patrick Kane has done it again to his hometown team. And that's his 20th goal of the year. He's hit that mark in every one of his 10 NHL seasons.
Hartman to Kane, a break time. Patrick Kane from a bad angle, surprising Mike Smith short side. And a shot right on. Good save by Crawford. Rebound is loose to Kane, just over the board. Kane to the net with Carroll. He waits, he shoots, he scores! Here's Panarin looking for Kane. He shoots it. He scores! Patrick Kane snapped home his hat-trick goal, his 23rd of the year.
Stolen away and turned back on now to Kane in a two-on-one. He's got Panarin. Kane scores! And carried back out by Panarin. Nudged it on through for the carry back one by Schmaltz across. Score!
Panarin sent back ahead, punched along by Haglund, dug out by King, jammed in! A hat trick!
Well, he missed earlier in that sequence for the hat trick on an easy shot. This time he decides to go from a bad angle on his backhand through traffic to the back of the net. Superstar professional scorer just making it look easy.
Not an easy play, but Patrick Kane making it look easy and the reigning MVP of the National Hockey League. Second hat trick in three games.
And then there's a construction worker also walking through the background. Yeah. I have no idea why. And I guarantee you that person is not a construction worker. Oh, look at that.
Oh, yeah.
Like he's just walking through that construction worker.
Just random just, construction just random. Worker. Just
so we have a fourth
some
microphone.
Stuff done.
Oh, so the construction.
The shop.
Just gonna do some stuff.
Do a little repair work around here. Yeah, it's right up
just
here.
Just walk in here so you're on camera.
I don't want the roof to fall on.
You don't want the roof. Yet,
so. It's right here.
Okay, so we got this construction worker walking
what's your name,
in.
Young man.
This guy right with the headset Patrice. And
yeah,
the vest.
Right here, Patrice, right up there. Okay. Yeah, it's not looking good. Here, okay. Let me bump out of here.
You know what we're going to do? We're going to bring the construction worker, the maintenance guy, on the show. Are you okay to do that?
I almost murdered a former GM.
Okay.
Don't want to get hurt here, you know?
No.
The boys on TMZ,
got a big day tomorrow. So.
Jeff?
Yeah? You work on Saturdays?
You work Saturdays, construction worker? Yeah.
You got to cut a better deal.
Honestly, if you're driving around, we have this guy in a safety vest and a hard hat and a drill come in.
Should be good, guys.
And
thank you. Hands out on the guy, eh?
Can you set him up with a microphone, Jeffy, and you sit down?
Yeah, you know,
he's got a step ladder.
To randomly bring people off the street for interviews. I don't know if you know anything about hockey, but grab a seat. Yeah.
Right, cool. So
not
I just.
Sure if you know anything, but we'll find out.
So do you? Are you a big fan? Before you, we'll get you to sit down.
Good to meet you.
Here's our construction worker. You watch the show when you're not fixing things around?
Watch the show all the time.
Yeah?
Yeah. Any chance I get.
Anybody, just get you to lean right into the microphone. Anybody ever tell you that you look like that guy Patrick from Chicago?
Yeah, a couple times.
Yeah.
I'm not sure who that is, but.
He's a pretty talented guy. Ladies and gentlemen.
Hey, nice pass to this Ponic guy yesterday behind the net. Real nice.
Ladies and gentlemen, Patrick Kane of the Chicago Blackhawks has joined us, and he's dressed.
We proudly select from the London Knights, the Ontario Hockey League, Patrick Kane.
Your reputation for being a big-time player in big-time moments, I think, really started in 2009.
Mm-hmm.
Do you remember the quote Willie Mitchell gave you in 2009?
Yeah, I think
kind of challenged you a little bit.
You know what's funny about that? I remember this quote here. He's not a guy who's really going to hurt us at even strength. Maybe just worry about him on the power play. And I remember I walked on the bus. I think it was the morning of game one, and I was walking by, and Scotty Bowman just handed me the paper to read it, almost like the motivation was coming from Scotty too. So I remember thinking about that. I'm like, all right, well, you know, this could be a moment where I could. Really prove someone wrong.
Here's Kane with Taves.
It's the hat trick in game six here.
Yeah.
I actually thought I put that backhand a little bit too far, and it was just kind of one of those nights where things were going in and ended up hitting the post and coming back in. And I remember just skating down the ice here, and I had, you know, chills running down my spine because how loud the building was. Jumped right into Brian Campbell's arms. It was a pretty fun moment.
And a year later, 2010, you had chills down your spine again, but you were the only one that knew.
Yeah, this one was a little different, obviously. I think
Get out of my way.
I think I'm just trying to sell the celebration here. I've actually had bad dreams about it where the puck doesn't go in and it's going around and I'm jumping up and down the ice. Philly comes back and wins. So fortunately enough, it went in there.
2013, revenge against the Kings. Another
elimination
game.
Yeah, this might be one of my favorite goals. Just the whole combination, winning in overtime, a great pass by Johnny, putting it up upstairs on quick like that, and you know the hat trick goal to send us to the Stanley Cup, and the celebration in there too is it's a fun one.
Appropriate that it was with Taves?
Yeah, I think so. I mean. Actually, right before that, we had a two-on-one, and he shot the puck, and I told him, you know, maybe you can fall back a little bit behind it. You could throw it back. I might have a good chance to try and one-time it in. And sure enough, we get that play the next shift, and he made a great pass, put it right on a platter for me.
The first half of your career, people might see the link between you and Taves, but in the second one, it might be you and Panarin.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you know, obviously you find that that linemate that you can play with. This goal was funny because he...
What's going on here?
Well,
I've never seen this before. It's like a stare-off.
He was telling me for about, like, 20 minutes before the game that I haven't given him a good pass in, like, the past three or four games. So here we are 5 minutes in. I just kind of, I gave him a nice pass there. He one-times it in, so we're just kind of looking at each other like, like, what? What now, you know?
Okay, first of all, like, it's a stare-off.
Yeah.
And you flinched first.
Yeah,
you should have kept it going. You're the one with the Conn Smythe and the cups and the top 100. Like, you can't flinch there first.
We should have kept it going. I actually think it could have went a lot longer. But I just figured I'd just, you know, kind of punch him.
Touches the puck, all eyes are on him, and you can kind of feel there's a palpable buzz in the building when he gets the puck, because you know something's going to happen.
And here comes Kane. He scores! Kane was shot back by Boland. Kane scores!
This historic pick. First time ever the Chicago Blackhawks have had the first pick, and we proudly select Patrick Kane.
I remember, you know, going to the bathroom maybe 5 or 10 times in the last hour because I was so nervous before the draft, but Chicago eventually got up and I made their first overall pick in the history of the franchise and ended up being my name, so pretty exciting moment and something I'll never forget.
You know, he played his first 9 games as an 18-year-old right after his draft, and I think he scored almost 2 points a game. He lit it up pretty good, so I think there's no doubt that he was sticking around.
18, 19 years old playing in the NHL, I mean, that's pretty much every kid's dream, so I had a lot of fun. The team was on the rise. We didn't make the playoffs that year, but it was a good year overall to kind of get your feet wet and play in the NHL.
With 21 goals and 51 assists, the Buffalo native was awarded the Calder Trophy as the top rookie in 2008. And the ascension of one of the league's most electrifying talents and a powerhouse team in the Windy City continued together as a nearly 5-decade Stanley Cup drought was ended 2 seasons later.
The shot that he took in the Stanley Cup final in 2010 against the Philadelphia Flyers surprised me. I thought he was going to pass the puck. He shot that from the bottom of the left wing circle and it went into the net. Everybody in the building was stunned. Everybody thought that the play was still going on. And it was actually in the net. But to me, that's the magic of Patrick Kane. He just seems to make the play that he feels is the right play at the right time.
A pretty amazing moment to score that overtime winning goal. I think as a kid, that's something to dream of, to be able to do that at the highest level, you know, in the NHL playoffs. Help win a Stanley Cup for the Blackhawks, first in the 49 years. It was a pretty fun moment. It's still a moment to this day that I don't know is really sunk in, but pretty cool to say he did that.
Kane, firmly cemented as a cornerstone of the franchise, helped the Blackhawks secure another Stanley Cup in 2013 while earning the Conn Smythe Trophy. And he won the Stanley Cup a third time 2 years later. In the 2015-16 season, Kane became the first American-born player ever to win the Art Ross Trophy, Hart Trophy, and Ted Lindsay Award.
He's a proven winner, 3 Stanley Cups. He's the most exciting player in the NHL right now.
Adds that ability when he does have the puck, he can make things happen, and he's even more dangerous as he progresses.
I still have a bunch of fun playing this game. I still enjoy being on the ice, so, you know, that's always motivation in itself.